What's up, people? This is YSHQ, and today I'm going to show you how to control the Raspberry Pi's GPIOs over the web. So over here, I'll be using a .php file to control them. This web page is for my home automation project, which I'll be working on the next couple of weeks. So headquarters is my room's name. Light one, light two, and fan one. These are the three devices which I'll be controlling using these three buttons. All these buttons are linked to GPIOs. This one to GPIO 0, GPIO 1, and GPIO 2. Let's go over to PuTTY and type in GPIO read all. Over here, you can see that GPIO 0, 2, and 3 are set as output ports with 1 and with 2 and 3 as 1-1. Over here, as you can see, the GPIO 0, 2, and 3 are all outputs and with the values of 1-1-1. Now, if you click on light 1, it will turn it off and set it to 0, like so. If you click on fan 1's button, it will turn the fan 1 off, like so. See? So the code that I've used here, I'll be explaining it. So I started it with HTML, then head. In the head, I put in three if conditions. Now to start it with, I use shell underscore x and in the brackets GPIO mode 0 out. What this will do is it will execute shell commands, which will be done by shell underscore exec. And the GPIO mode 0 out, this will change the mode of the GPIO 0, which is the pin number 7 to output. Sorry, pin number 11 to output. Similarly for 2 and 3. Now this one, $BTN, $BTN, $BTN. Let's give them BTN 1, 2, and 3. So what this will do is that it will set the variable $BTN1. It will write the value of the GPIO 0. Similarly for BTN 2, the value of GPIO 2, BTN 3, value of GPIO 3. The value on this will be as shown. GPIO read 2. As this gave an output 1, this means that this value, the V value, would be displayed. Similarly for GPIO read 3, the value 0 should be shown as seen. In the next line, I put in if else commands. If is set $_post_L1, what this will do is that it will go to the body. Then it will, if we go into the body, we can see that light 1 is the column over here. I've set this all in a table format, hence it is easier to manipulate them. Then for the on off button, I've set the name as L1, and hence if the name L1 is called, it will go to this line. If is set _post. Now if button 1 is equal to 1, then it will execute the GPIO write 0. What this will do, that if the value of the GPIO 0 is equal to 1, then it will change it to 0, and hence it could revert it. Similarly for button 2 and button 3, like so. Button 2 equal to 1, write 0, else write 1. Now in the next lines, the title, which will be shown over here, it is the home automation system. Next, body style. So the background is a bit grayish, and hence the RGB code is as follows. Next, I wanted to align everything in the center, and hence align center. Then I gave it a break to come on to the next line. Then I changed the font size, the font face, and the color to white, which is these. Next, I went onto the table. I have two tables. One is the outer one and one is the inner one. The outer table has two columns. The headquarters and the other column which would have all the which would house the next table. Over here, table row which would list the headquarters, that is the first row, and the second row it would house the other table, which is the table which has all these values. Light 1 on off, light 2 on off, light 3 on off. These on offs are buttons which can be seen here. Button style, I set the height and width as follows and the name L1. I changed the font size and the font color, and then this value is the value which would be displayed over here. Similarly, it is done for the other two. Now, to implement this, you have to paste this file into the var/www/html folder, and the name would be as follows, or any other name which you will have to type in the address bar. So let's take it for example, like I edited this file. I'll just drag and drop it over here. It will ask if I want to change it, and yes. And if I refresh this page, it will change it. Let's take for example, let's convert one button to control the GPIO 21. What I'll do is simply, I'll just go over here, I'll give the middle button 21 21 21 and 21. That's all. I'll just save this page and refresh the web page. Now on clicking light 2, they should change the mode of GPIO 21 to output and 1. As you can see, output and 1. If I click it again, it will change the mode to output and 0. I made a mistake. I didn't put the correct variable names, and hence it was taking any random value. Clicking it again, as you can see, the value changed from 1 to 0. From 1 to 0. Now, extra functionalities can also be added, like running a Python script using the same shell_exec command. Now, if I want to put a shutdown button, all I'll do is just copy this whole thing, paste, then change it from fan to shutdown. I'll change this to OK. If I save, and this to SD, just for the name. Now I'll just copy these lines, copy, paste, post. As I change the name to SD, I'll be typing in SD. And for shutdown, there will be no need of if else, hence I'll be removing all the if else. Then shell_exec in the bracket. Sudo shutdown now. Saving this and running this file again, refreshing this page again. Oh sorry, I forgot to copy over this page, this file onto the server. Yes. It throws an error. Okay, I forgot the last thing, the semicolon, and now it should work. Right there, see? Then next, let's run some Python script. Let's go create a new Python script. Sudo. Now this would have these lines. What we would do is just save it, then go into the home directory, py, then there'll be a file as test1.py. There it is. Just copy it. Now again go into the HTML file. Now just copy this file here and say replace. As we had earlier that the GPIO 6 was as an input port. Now by just going here, clicking on Python, now you can see that the value changes from input to output, and the V from 0 to 1. So using this method, you can do a number of things that you want to do with the GPIOs.
So thank you people for watching this video. Like this video or dislike it. Subscribe to the channel, share it, go through my other videos, and see you next time. Ta-da!